In this video, we'll talk about how you can add, move, and remove clips from your projects. Let's get started. I'll start by selecting a clip from the browser, which loads up into the viewer on the right. And from there, you can see that I already have in and out points marked for this clip. So if I wanted to add just that portion of this clip to the project, one way to do that is to simply tap and hold on the video clip in the viewer and drag that onto the timeline. You'll notice the yellow eye bar showing me where that clip is going to be added. In this case, it's going to be added right at the end of that existing clip, but if I move my finger just a little bit to the left, a yellow box draws around the existing clip, showing me that I'm going to replace that clip. And if I keep on dragging over, we'll eventually see the eye bar pop up between those two existing clips, telling me that I'm going to be inserting it between those. I could also choose to add this clip to another track, or if I drag it down to the audio tracks, it'll add only the audio. Notice that the clip turns green, denoting that it's audio only, whereas here it's blue, showing me that it's video and audio. I'm actually not going to add it yet because I want to show you another way to do this. Again, this clip already has the in and out points marked on it, so I'm going to go ahead and tap and drag this clip from the browser itself directly onto the timeline. Or I can simply double tap on the clip to add it to the timeline, and that'll drop it wherever the playhead currently is. Because a range of this clip has already been marked, only that range will be added to the timeline, which is important because I can actually pre-mark multiple clips to add different pieces of multiple clips at once. So for example, let's say that I wanted to add this shot, and then this shot to the timeline. I've already gone through and marked the ranges of those shots that I want to use. So now with the first shot selected, I'll tap the multi-selector tool here, and you'll notice that the clip now has a number 1 on it, and then I'll tap this clip, which now gets a 2, and this clip, which now gets a 3. From here, I can tap and drag on these clips onto the timeline, and all three of those shots have just been added. Finally, there's yet another way to add our clips to the timeline. I'll load a new clip and get rid of the multi-selector tool, navigate to the end of the timeline here, and with this clip selected, notice here we have an insert clip icon. If I tap on that, it'll drop it right onto the timeline. Now in this case, because the playhead was at the end of the timeline, it just added it to the end of the project. However, if I undo that and then position the playhead between two existing clips, and if I want to make sure that I get exactly to the spot between the clips, I could use the Event Navigator tool. Now, when I select this clip and tap the Insert button, it drops it onto the timeline and pushes the existing clip out of the way. This is an important distinction. What we're doing now is insert editing. We are inserting one shot between others. There's also an overwrite editing mode that will actually overwrite a piece or all of a clip, and we're going to look at that in the next chapter. But for now, we're talking about insert editing. If I want to get rid of a clip that's on the timeline, I can select it and then tap the delete icon here. If I want to move a clip around on the timeline, I can simply tap and hold it and then move it wherever I'd like. And you'll see that I have the same commands as I had before. I can overwrite a clip or insert it somewhere else, or even move it onto a different track or drag it down to the audio-only tracks. Finally, if I want to split a clip, let's say that I wanted to insert something right in the middle of this shot here, I could do that with these scissor tools. Now, before I show that to you, let me show you where this doesn't work. If I have the playhead positioned precisely between two clips, you'll notice that the scissor tool is grayed out because there's nothing for it to trim. However, if the playhead is over a clip that it can cut, then the tool is available. If I tap it now, it's going to go ahead and trim that clip. But what happens if you have multiple clips on the timeline? Here you'll notice that I have two clips stacked on top of each other. If I select one of them and tap the scissors icon, it's going to trim just that one clip. I'll undo that, and with no clip selected, when I tap the scissors icon, it trims all of the clips under the playhead. Finally, as you've undoubtedly already noticed, on the right-hand side, we have the undo as well as the redo buttons. And those are your basic editing tools. Now you've seen how to add your clips to the timeline, adding multiple clips at once even, moving them around, and cutting them to pieces if you need to. In the next chapter, we're going to talk about some more advanced editing techniques, including that overwrite mode that I mentioned earlier.